Yes, sir, I do.
Tell me just about what the mindset was in the minutes. I think they weren't giving me too much questions they usually do.
Well, things just weren't opening up, and I could have probably broke more tackles, and it could have worked both ways. But Sutton did a great job of stopping the run first half, and I think mostly it was on our part because when I did say something to them, they responded, and things are opening up. So I don't talk much, but I feel like I needed to at that point, and they responded well. I can't remember what I said.
Nick, Coach talked about business approach you guys had in practice yesterday. How much of that is the fact that it is a big game, but it's also going to be October 3rd, a lot of room still left to go?
Oh, yeah, man. It's kind of a defining moment for us because we haven't really faced adversity in the game, and that's kind of what you want to see in the team. You know, how can they handle adversity in a close game? How can you handle that? I think we've kind of blown out every team we played so far, so I know it won't be a blowout this game either way. So I think whoever wins, it'll be a close game. So I think it'll be good for us to see what kind of team we are.
You've been pretty clear about not caring, I guess, lack of a better word, about the 100-yard streak. But obviously, when you get 100 yards, I mean, it means the running game is working and it's overall good for the offense. So how much of a motivation is that number this week?
I think I'm more motivated to get 100 yards, not because of to break the record, but just because they haven't allowed anyone to get 100 yards on them this season. And I know my line is also very excited about, they're probably more excited about breaking a record.
Yeah.
Because being a part of this, what we have going on, so I think it'll be very interesting to see what happens.
How much has Sony helped you get better this year and both, in the past year?
I mean, he helped a lot. I know he's able to come in and take a lot of load off of me because it was a lot of pressure coming in. Just everyone just focused on me. He's came and he's taking control of a lot of things. And I mean, he's helped me on the field, practice field, working hard every day. And everywhere in general, he's helped me.
When you guys both committed here, you're both sort of highly rated running backs. And a lot of times, guys will sort of avoid that. So, you know, going in as a freshman, what'd you sort of think of him, you know, as a person?
I mean, he was a good dude, cool dude. He's very funny. And I don't know.
what jumps out at you about Alabama's front seven?
Can you say that again?
Alabama's front seven, when you look at some tape, anything, you know, do they look like a different group than you faced in Georgia?
I haven't watched that much film, but I've seen them. They're very physical guys, and they're very disciplined in what they do, and they'll hit you hard, and then they won't back down. They're not soft at all.
You were heavily recruited out of high school, obviously, but how much of a look did you give Bama before committing to Georgia?
Not much at all. Probably went there two or three times. I just really wasn't interested in them. I don't know why.
So you talked about superstitions a few weeks ago. I assume your mom will be at the game this weekend. Who's going to leave your bathroom light on back in the secret time?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure someone does.
What do you have any pregame rituals?
No, I don't.
You don't? Not a particular music you listen to? And
oh, yeah, I listen to them. Not really a song, but just the same type of music, just calm music.
You don't have anything like take my left ankle first or my left leg? You know, superstitious that way?
Not that way, no, sir.